بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده ولا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. وصلنا إلى باب وهو من أخطر الأبواب كما ذكرنا، وهو باب السب والاستهزاء والسخرية إما بالله أو بآيات الله الشرعية والكونية أو بالأنبياء والرسل عليهم الصلاة والسلام. نعم.
بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. وبعد، just before we start, those brothers who are listening to lessons, please come forward, move forward and sit close. So in the previous lesson, we took and we studied the most important chapter, or a very important chapter, and a very dangerous subject. And this is relating to a person insulting or mocking or joking about the Lord or the signs of Allah, the religion of Allah and the Messenger.
ثم أن المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى ذكر باب وبوب لآية من القرآن، وهذا فيه أن المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى يسير على طريقة البخاري رحمه الله تعالى، والبخاري أراد ألا يدخل شيئا في كتابه إلا ما كان من الكتاب والسنة. نعم.
And then after this, then the author, he mentioned another chapter, and he started this chapter by mentioning an ayah from the Quran. And this is the same he did, this is the same that Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah used to do. They never wanted to put into their books something which wasn't from the speech of Allah and the speech of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
هو الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة، النفس الواحدة، آدم عليه الصلاة والسلام.
So Allah says that He is the one who created you from a single being, and that single being is Adam alayhi salam.
وجعل منها زوجها أي حواء.
And then He created from this single being His wife, أي حواء.
ليسكن إليها.
So that he could find tranquility in her.
السكون هو سكون للشهوة وسكون مودة ورحمة. نعم.
So the meaning of سكون here is either a person fulfilling his desires and also a person finding love and comfort.
فسكون الشهوة والله لا يمكن أن ينطفئ إلا بالنكاح الزواج الصحيح أو بالتسري الشروط التي ذكرها العلماء رحمهم الله تعالى.
So therefore, in terms of a person fulfilling his desires, then this can only be done by either the correct Islamic form of nikah or at-sarri.
فالنكاح الآن الذي جاءت به الشريعة وتحريم، نسأل الله العافية والسلامة، الزنا، فلا يمكن أن تنطفئ الشهوة إلا بما جاءت به الشريعة. نعم.
So therefore, the prohibition against committing adultery and a person fulfilling his desires in a wrong way, then the only way for a person out of this is with the marriage which is Islamically correct.
فكيف تكون الوقاية من الفتن؟
So therefore, how should a person protect himself from fitan?
وبخاصة في هذا الباب، في باب النساء.
So how should a person protect himself from these fitan? Here the meaning of fitan is related to desires, الشهوات.
لأن هذه من أخطر الفتن.
Because this is from the most dangerous forms of fitan.
الأول، إن استطاع أن يتزوج بادر بالنكاح بالزواج الصحيح بشروطه.
Firstly, if a person has the ability to marry, then he should quickly marry as long as the conditions are fulfilled.
فإن لم يستطع.
And if a person does not have the ability to marry,
يصوم.
Then he should fast.
وبالصيام يقلل من الطعام والشراب، وهذا يقلل من أثر الشهوة.
And by a person fasting, then a person is eating less and drinking less. And by eating and drinking less, then the effects of these desires is also weakened.
فإذا لا يكثر من الطعام ولا من الشراب، وبخاصة الأغذية أو الأشربة التي تزيد من الشهوة.
And therefore a person shouldn't eat or drink a lot, and especially those foods that increase a person's desires.
صحبة الصالحين.
And also from the ways of a person protecting himself against these fitna and desires is having friends or companions who are righteous people.
زيارة القبور الزيارة الشرعية لأنها تذكر الآخرة. فإذا لعب بك الشيطان خاصة في هذا الباب في باب النساء وكذا تذهب إلى القبور زيارة شرعية بإذن الله يذهب عنك ما تجد.
And also a person visiting the graves as should be done so in the Islamic manner, because when a person visits the grave, he reminds himself of the hereafter.
الابتعاد عن أماكن الفتن الأسواق وغيرها.
And also a person staying far away from those places where these fitan and these desires are present, i.e. the marketplaces and the town centers as an example.
عدم المطالعة والدخول في هذه المواقع والإنترنت إطلاقا حتى لو غير هذه الأجهزة الحديثة بجهاز قديم يكون أحسن.
And a person staying away from the internet, absolutely, even if a person was to change these technology, these mobile phones and computers with something which is old.
دعاء الله سبحانه وتعالى.
And also a person supplicating to Allah.
وإلا تصرف عني كيدهن أصب إليهن وأكن من الجاهلين.
And as Yusuf عليه السلام, he supplicated to Allah and he said that if you do not protect me from the plots of these women.
وإلا تصرف عني كيدهن أصب إليهن وأكن من الجاهلين.
That I will fall into it and I will become from the jahilin, from the ignorant ones.
لا يكون في مكان خاليا وحده.
A person shouldn't remain in particular places alone.
وخاصة أوقات الأعياد والاحتفالات.
And especially go to certain places alone when there's celebrations and festivals.
غض البصر.
And also a person lowering his gaze.
تتذكر بما أعد الله سبحانه وتعالى لك إذا ابتعدت عن الحرام. من ترك شيئا لله عوضه الله خيرا. تثق أن الله سبحانه وتعالى معوضك خيرا من هذا الذي تركت. نعم.
And also a person should remember that which Allah has promised for a person who leaves things for his sake. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever leaves a matter for the sake of Allah, then Allah gives him something which is even better. And therefore, a person has complete certainty and trust in the promise of Allah.
تعلم أن الزنا نسأل الله العافية والسلامة دين. عندما تصنع شيء بغيرك سوف يصنع بأهلك. إن الزنا دين كما قال الإمام الشافعي رحمه الله تعالى. من يزني يزنى به ولو بجداره.
And also remember the statement of Imam al-Shafi'i rahimullah, who said that this action of adultery is like a loan that has been taken out. That if you commit an act of adultery, then the same thing will be done with somebody who is close to you.
احفظ الله يحفظك.
And also Allah said that preserve and protect the commandments of Allah and Allah will protect and preserve you.
ثم أخواننا لا يمكن أن نعجب بالمشركات وأنه يتحدث بهذا الكلام بعض الطلاب هدانا الله إياهم. نعم. ولأمتم مؤمنة خير من مشركة ولو أعجبتكم. نعم.
And also it's not permissible for us to become amazed by these disbelieving women and the women of a shirk. And Allah said in the Quran that a believing slave woman is better than these mushrikat, these disbelieving women, even if you are amazed by them.
لا يتكلم الطالب في هذه المسائل إطلاقا في مسألة النساء والنكاح وهذه المسائل, لأنه قال بعض السلف جنبوا مجالسنا ذكر شهوة الفرج وشهوة الفم. فطالب العلم ما يتكلم في هذه المسائل إطلاقا. نعم.
So therefore a student of knowledge, he should not speak about these things at all, about women and desires and things like this. And for this reason some of the salaf, the imams of the past, they used to say that avoid or leave our sittings free from mentioning the desires that relate to a person's private parts and the desires of the tongue.
تقوى الله.
And also a person having taqwa of Allah, being conscious and
تجعل بينك وبين عذاب الله وقاية وحاجز بفعل الأوامر واجتناب النواهي محبة وتعظيما.
And that a person should place between himself and the punishment of Allah a barrier. And this barrier is fulfilling the commandments of Allah and staying away from everything which Allah has prohibited.
تشتغل بطلب العلم بالحفظ دائما تكون في المسجد ولا ترجع إلى البيت إلا وأنت منهك متعب تريد النوم.
And also another way of us protecting ourselves from these desires and these fitna is occupy your time and yourselves with learning and studying and memorizing Quran, stay in the masjid for a long time, and you only go home when you're tired.
بعض الناس نسأل الله العافية السلامة هو مفتوح في نفسه فماذا يصنع؟ ينشر هذه الفتنة ويدعو إليها فيأتيك يقول والله يا أخي ما استطعت حضور الدورة. نعم.
Some people, may Allah guide us and guide them, they are tested within themselves, i.e. with these type of desires. And then what do? They go around spreading this problem or speaking about it. So they'll say, for example, that I wasn't able to come to this conference.
نعم يقول ما استطيع أفتح كتاب التوحيد أراها أمامي مثلا.
And he says, look, even when I open كتاب التوحيد, I see this woman in front of me.
يعني هو مفتون في نفسه وأراد أن يفتن الطلاب كذلك.
Meaning, this person has been tested by this problem himself, then at the same time he wants to spread this problem amongst the people.
الإشكال عندنا حتى في بعض المتزوجين لا يراعي حقوق العزاب. نعم.
And also we have some brothers who are married and yet they don't think about the rights or the needs of those who are single.
يعني عندما يمشي وهو خارج من المسجد داخل يأخذ بيد زوجته هكذا وفي البيت قد انه لا يمس يدها. لا يصح هذا اخوانا, لابد ان تراعي شعور هؤلاء. نعم قد تكون سبب في وقوع هؤلاء في الفتنة وفي المعصية بأمر يسير تترك ولا إشكال في هذا. ولهذا جاء الحجاب وحرم الاختلاط. إخوانا عندنا مسائل قد تكون يسيرة لكن تؤدي إلى ما هو إلى ما لا يحمد عقباها. نعم.
And also, as mentioned, the married people, they have to think about the thoughts of those who are single. So for example, sometimes we have a person stands outside the masjid and he holds the hand of his wife.
كذلك
without thinking about, you know, what's happening to what the single people might be thinking. So for example, he holds the hand of his wife, and yet when he's in his house and nobody sees him, maybe he's never held the hand of his wife. So this is something which can be left quite easily, and it won't be a reason for fitna for those who are not married. For this reason, the hijab, for this reason, the free mixing of men and women was prevented. So sometimes we do something which is very little, or something which we belittle and we don't think much about, and yet it can lead to somebody doing something which isn't good.
ولذلك جاء النهي عن التحدث, أن يتحدث الزوج والزوجة بما حدث بينهما.
And for this reason, the prohibition came for a husband and a wife to speak to other people about things which are private between them.
البعد عن أماكن المعاصي واللهو غيره.
And a person staying away from the places of disobedience and sins and desires.
إذا أراد أن ينزل إلى السوق يتغضى وكذا ينزل في أوقات ليس فيها ازدحام أصلا أو في أماكن بعيدة. نعم سارقة.
So if a person, for example, he needs to go to the marketplace or go to the town centers, he needs to eat somewhere, then he should go when it isn't busy, there aren't a lot of people, he sits somewhere far away.
كذلك ما ذكر الشيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية رحمه الله تعالى في تفسير قوله تعالى.
And also what Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah رحمه الله mentioned in explaining the saying of Allah.
وَاللَّهُ يُرِيدُ أَن يَتُوبَ عَلَيْكُمْ.
That Allah, He wants to accept your repentance from you.
وَيُرِيدُ الَّذِينَ يَتَّبِعُونَ الشَّهَوَاتِ أَن تَمِيلُوا عَنِ الصَّرَاطِ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ.
And those people who follow their shahawat, their desires, then they want from you that you turn away from the straight path.
تَمِيلُوا مَيْلًا عَظِيمًا.
And that you deviate greatly.
يريد الله أن يخفف عنكم.
Allah wants to lessen this burden from upon you.
وخلق الإنسان ضعيفا, يعني الإنسان ضعيف في شأن النساء كما قال أهل التفسير. إذا ذكر له النساء ما استطاع أن يتحمل.
وخلق الإنسان ضعيفا. So Allah, He wants to lessen and lighten this burden from upon you, because man was created very weak. And the people of this tafsir, the scholars who explain the Quran, they mention that the meaning of weakness here is a weakness regarding the women. That when women are mentioned in front of men, they become weak.
فأغلق هذا الباب.
So therefore, we close this avenue straight away.
وكيف تشتغل بالحور الطين عن الحور العين؟ حور العين عفيفة. لا غيبة ولا نميمة. حديث تسمع لحديثها وكذا. كيف تشتغل بهذه الثانية التي يعني لديها كذا وكذا وحيض ونفاس وغيره، وأعد الله سبحانه وتعالى لك من الحور العين ما لا عين رأت ولا أذن سمعت ولا خطر عن قلب بشر.
So how is it that a person, he prefers the women who are made from this clay, from this dust here, with all their deficiencies and their faults, and he forgets about the women in Jannah, the Hur al-Ain. So the women in Jannah, the Hur al-Ain, the reward for those people who are pious, and they are in their perfect way, and how they have been created. And a person leaves off this, and instead concentrates on the women here, with their deficiencies.
كذلك يذكر شيخ الإسلام تنبيه مهم جدا لمن؟ للخطباء. بعض الخطباء هدانا الله إياهم يذكر أحيانا نعم.
And also Sheikh Hussam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, he mentions something regarding those people who give sermons, and lectures. And he says that sometimes those who give sermons, they say,
يقول يذكر قصص. يقول فلان التقى بفلانة وصنع بها كذا وكذا ولديها وصف كذا وكذا، فهذا يثير الشهوة عند السامعين، وهذا لا يجد أن يطفع الشهوة إلا في محرم. من السبب؟ السبب هذا الواعظ لأنه وعظ الناس بغير ما جاء في الكتاب والسنة.
So some people, some of those who give sermons and lectures and they admonish other people, when they do this, they do it in, by way of stories. They say this man, he met this woman, and she did this, and she was like this, and this, and this. And by this he's testing, and he's a tribulation for the people in front of him. And some of those people who are in front of him, the only way that they can fulfill their desires is that which is haram. So what is the reason that has made this person go and fulfill his desire in that which was haram? This person who was giving a sermon, or was admonishing the people, but he did it with something which isn't in the Qur'an or the Sunnah.
وكذلك بعض الطلاب هدانا الله إياه في صورة إنكار المنكر هو يدعو للمنكر. نعم.
And also some students of knowledge trying to or wanting to forbid the evil, he actually brings about the evil.
كيف؟
How is this?
يقول عندنا في قريتنا في يوم كذا يأتي كذا وكذا وكل شيء موجود بالمجان.
That he'll mention to the people in our village, in our town, on this day, there's this evil and there's this evil, and everything is available for anybody for free.
يقول هذا المستمع له يقول أعوذ بالله.
So then the one who is listening, he says أعوذ بالله, seek refuge in Allah.
وفي قلبه يقول جزاك الله. والله كذلك بعض الطلاب هدانا الله إياه. نعم.
فهموا.
بعض الطلاب هدانا الله إياه. يقول في موقع أعوذ بالله فهو بهذا يدعو للمنكر.
And also some students, may Allah guide them and guide us, they say in this particular website, and they name the website, you say أعوذ بالله, seek the refuge of Allah, and yet by mentioning the website he's calling to it.
أو يقول عندنا جارة تفعل وتفعل وتفعل وكذا كأنه يدل عليها نسأل الله عافية والسلام أو يثير الشهوة عندها، فهذا الباب أغلق هذا الباب واستريح. أي أحد من الطلاب يتكلم هذا الكلام قل اسمع لا تتكلم في هذا الباب تثير عندنا وقد أنت تكون سبب في ارتكاب المعاصي. نعم.
And also we have some students, they mention for example, you know, their neighbor, female neighbor, somebody that they know. And they say regarding this female neighbor that she does this and this and she's like this and she's like this. And all that they're doing is they're arousing the desires of the people. So whenever you find, so we should close this avenue straight away. And whenever you hear a student saying something like this, you say to him, look, don't mention these things amongst us.
قراءة سورة يوسف عليه الصلاة والسلام. إذا لعب بك الشيطان تقرأ سورة يوسف عليه الصلاة والسلام. تمنى السجن عن الوقوع في الفاحشة نسأل الله عافية والسلام. وتتعرف أن بعض الطلاب هدانا الله إياه يوسوس له الشيطان أنه يصنع كذا ويصنع ولو يتسنى لي كذا ويتسنى لي كذا. نعم.
And also one of the ways of protecting yourself against the plots and the whisperings of Shaitan is to read the story of Yusuf alayhi salam. Read Surah Yusuf and how Yusuf alayhi salam, how he preferred to go into prison, to be in prison rather than falling to the plots and the desires of the women.
أنت الآن في نعمة من الله أمدك بقوة وبقدرة على الجماع ومن ذلك. كيف تجعل هذه النعمة نقمة؟ كيف تكفر هذه النعمة؟ نسأل الله العافية والسلام.
And also you are in a position of being blessed, that this is a blessing, i.e. manhood, and the fact that you've been blessed with having the ability to fulfill your desires. So how is it that you turn this blessing of Allah now into something which is a cause for the anger of Allah and the punishment of Allah?
Allahumma akfina bi halalika an haramik wa ghnina bi fadlika amman siwak ya rabbi. ثم بعد هذا ذكر المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى باب قول الله تعالى ولله نعم أي لله لا لغيره نعم.
And then after this the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, he mentioned a chapter. He said chapter for Allah are, specifically for Allah are,
ولله الأسماء الحسنى البالغة في الحسن أكمله نعم.
That for Allah and only for Allah are the Asma'ul Husna, the beautiful names. The beautiful names mean the most perfect and most beautiful names.
فادعوه بها أي ندعو الله سبحانه وتعالى بهذه الأسماء دعاء عبادة ودعاء مسأل. دعاء عبادة نتعبد لله بمقتضى الأسماء. غفور تتعرض أسباب المغفرة. رحيم تتعرض أسباب الرحمة. سميع تحرص أن الله سبحانه وتعالى لا يسمع منك إلا ما يرضى. هذا دعاء عبادة.
And then Allah said in the completion of this ayah, فَادْعُوهُ بِهَا. So then supplicate to Allah and call out to Allah and worship Allah through these beautiful names. And this supplication to Allah through these beautiful names is the two types of supplication which we mentioned. I.e. dua al-ibadah, supplicating to Allah through your worship. So for example, because you know that Allah hears everything, then you try not to say anything which displeases Allah. Because you know that Allah is the most merciful, then you worship Allah in order to bring about this mercy or this forgiveness. And also that you worship, you supplicate to Allah with these beautiful names in asking and requesting from Him things in specific. Dua al-mas'ala.
Dua al-mas'ala. تقدم بين يدي السؤال اسم من أسماء الله سبحانه وتعالى مناسب لهذه المسألة. تقول يا رحيم ارحمني، يا حي يا قيوم برحمتك أستغيث. وعلى هذا وأحسن من هذا تأتي بالأدعية الواردة عن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام جامعة نافعة. نعم.
And in terms of dua al-mas'ala, i.e. a person supplicating to Allah for something specific, then the best way to do this is that you use the specific name which is appropriate to that which you are asking for. So for example, if you want the mercy of Allah, you say, Ya Rahman, O the one who is the most merciful, have mercy upon me. And like this, you choose appropriate names. You say, for example, Ya Hayy, O the one who is ever living, the one who sustains, then sustain me, for example. And better than all of this, instead of having your own personal dua, is that you use the supplications which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to say and used to supplicate to Allah with. Why? Because they are encompassing and they are the most beneficial.
كيف يكون هذا؟ بدراسة هذا الباب أي باب الأسماء والصفات. نعم في الكتاب والسنة الصحيحة.
So how is a person going to fulfill this aspect of supplication? By studying the names and attributes of Allah in the books of At-Tawheed and the Quran and the authentic Sunnah.
ثم قال سبحانه وتعالى وذروا أيتركوا.
And then Allah سبحانه وتعالى said in the same ayah وذروا أي leave alone.
الذين يلحدون أي يدخلون في أسماء الله سبحانه وتعالى ما ليس منها.
And leave alone, be far away from those people who have ilhad in the names of Allah, i.e. those people who give names to Allah and they are not His names.
God.
Calling Him God.
وغير هذا.
And these are the names.
أو يسمي الله بما لم يسمي به نفسه.
And again, another form of ilhad is to to call Allah, to give Allah a name which isn't His name. For example, they call Him first of the third, I Trinity.
أو ينكر الأسماء كلها أو بعضها.
And also a way of a type of ilhad, a type of deviation, the names and attributes of Allah is for a person to negate the names of Allah, a single name or all of the names of Allah.
أو يثبت الاسم وينكر الصفة.
Or for a person to affirm the name of Allah, but then negate the meaning behind this name.
نعم. ثم بعد هذا ذكر المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى باب النهي عن قول السلام على الله. نعم.
And then after this, the author he mentioned a chapter where he said the prohibition of saying السلام, peace.
السلام اسم من أسماء الله. أي المنزه عن كل نقص وعيب. نعم.
So the meaning of السلام here, this is the name of Allah, and السلام is Allah is free and above any type of defect.
نعم. فلا يقال السلام على الله. ماذا نقول؟
So we don't say السلام upon Allah. What should we say?
نقول التشهد, لأن الصحابة رضي الله عليهم كانوا يقول السلام على الله من عباده. ف علمهم النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام يقول التحيات لله والصلوات والطيبات. نعم.
Instead, it is better for a person to say the التحيات لله, the تشهد.
نعم. بعد هذا جاء المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى بباب النهي عن الاستثناء في الدعاء. يعني النهي عن قول اللهم اغفر لي, اللهم ارحمني إن شئت. نهي أن يقول مع الدعاء إن شئت. يقول اللهم اغفر لي, اللهم ارحمني. يجزم ويقطع بالسؤال. نعم.
And then the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, he brought the next chapter in which he said the prohibition for a person to say, oh Allah forgive me if you want, oh Allah have mercy upon you, upon me if you want. So this is a prohibition from having this restriction, if you want. Rather a person should say, oh Allah forgive me, oh Allah have mercy upon me. And he's sure about his question or his supplication.
لأن هذا الاستثناء كأنك تقول إن استطعت يا رب أن تصنع هذا لي اصنع هذا لي. سبحان الله, هل يقال هذا في حق الله؟ لا. نعم.
So by saying this, if you will or if you are able to do so, it's as if you're saying that Allah forgive me if you can do so. And if is this something that should be mentioned regarding Allah?
كذلك أورد المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى محرم لفظي. إنه لا يقول عبدي وأمتي, يقول فتاي وفتاتي وغلامي, لأن هذا فيه إذلال للعبد وفي تعدي على جانب الربوبية لله سبحانه وتعالى. نعم.
And also, and after this, the next chapter, the author, rahimullah, he mentioned certain words that are prohibited just in terms of the wording itself. So for example, he said that you shouldn't say عبدي وأمتي, my slave or my slave woman. Rather say غلامي, my servant, for example, or my maid.
نعم. وهذا فيه أن الشريعة إذا أغلقت باب المحرم فتحت باب الجواز. نعم.
So in this is a benefit that whenever the Sharia comes and it closes an avenue which is prohibited and it is haram, it opens another avenue which is permissible.
كذلك أورد المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى حديث لا يسأل بوجه الله إلا الجنة. أولا في هذا الحديث. نعم. في هذا الحديث.
After this, the author he bought another chapter, and he mentioned.
فيه أن المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى أراد أننا إذا سألنا الله سبحانه وتعالى بوجهه لا نسأل إلا غاية المطالب, الجنة أو ما يؤدي إليها.
And in this chapter, he mentioned that you should not ask by the face of Allah anything except al-jannah. Meaning, if you are going to ask something by the face of Allah, you say as'aluka biwajhi, I ask you by the face of Allah, then you should only ask that which is the absolute best, i.e. jannah, paradise.
أو ما يؤدي إليها.
Or anything which leads a person to paradise.
اللهم إني أعوذ بوجهك من النار. هذا يؤدي إلى الجنة.
So a person can say, for example, oh Allah, I seek refuge by your face from the fire, because this then leads a person to paradise.
إذا لا يسأل بوجه الله زوجة صالحة أو أثاث جميل مثلا.
So a person shouldn't say, oh Allah, I ask by your face a righteous wife, for example, or beautiful property.
وفي هذا الحديث إثبات صفة الوجه لله سبحانه وتعالى. فأهل السنة والجماعة يثبتون لله سبحانه وتعالى وجه حقيقي يليق بجلاله عظمته لا ماثل وجه المخلوقين. نعم.
So in this hadith or in this supplication, in this hadith is an affirmation for the face of Allah. أهل السنة والجماعة, they affirm that Allah has a face, however the face of Allah is befitting to His Majesty.
نعم. ثم ذكر المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى استعمال لو. ما أدري عاد في اللغة الإنجليزية كيف يكون استعمال لو.
And then after this, the author, may Allah mercy upon him, he mentioned another chapter. And that is the statement of the people, low, like if only this was, or if only I hadn't done.
لو أني فعلت كذا لكان كذا وكذا.
I.e. somebody saying, if only I had done this, then this and this would have happened.
يعني ذكر المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى استعمالات للو ستة. نعم.
So the author, may Allah mercy upon him, he mentioned six instances wherein a person would use this type of phrase, if only.
استعمال لو في الاعتراض على الشريعة, على الكتاب والسنة. نعم. استعمال لو عندما أمر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الجيش بالخروج إلى أحد وحدث ما حدث من الهزيمة, قال أهل النفاق لو أطاعونا, يعني لو كان الأمر لنا لا إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لم يحدث ما حدث من الهزيمة. نعم.
So the first type of low saying if only is when somebody is using it in order to contest something from the Sharia, As an example, when the Battle of Uhud happened and that which occurred with the Muslims occurred, i.e. some of the loss that they suffered, then the people of hypocrisy, the Ahl al-Nifaq, the people of hypocrisy, they said, لو أطاعونا, that if only had they obeyed us, then this loss wouldn't have occurred.
إذن هنا استعمال لو في الاعتراض على تشريع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بخروج الجيش الأحد مثلا.
So in this instance, as an example, this word low or this phrase if only, it was being used to contest the ruling of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
وهذا محرم لا شك في تحريمه.
And this is haram, this is forbidden, and there's no doubt that it is forbidden.
الثاني أن تستعمل لو في الاعتراض على القضاء والقدر.
And then the second type or the second instance where a person would use this phrase if only is when he is contesting against the decree of Allah.
هذا يريد الذهاب مثلاً إلى المنزل.
So for example, this brother, he wants to go to his house.
تقول له لا لا تذهب الآن.
You say to him, no, don't go now.
يذهب ويقدر الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يحصل له حادث مروري.
So he leaves and he goes, and by the decree of Allah, he has a violation of the traffic, for example.
هذا أمر كتبه الله.
So this is now an affair or an event which Allah legislated, or it happened with the decree of Allah.
نعم لا بد أن يرضى.
So therefore, he has to now become pleased and happy.
فيقول له لو أطعتني ما حصل لك ما حصل من الحادث وغيره.
And then this person says to him, if only you had listened to what I was saying, then this wouldn't have happened to you.
يعني هنا لو في الاعتراض على القضاء والقدر.
So therefore, this phrase now, if only, is being used in order to contest against the decree of Allah.
الاستعمال الثالث.
The third instance in which this phrase can be used or is used
على التحسر والندم, يندم على ما فات,
is when a person is extremely apologetic or sad or worried of something that has happened previously.
نقول لو فعلت كذا لحصل كذا, لو قدمت, لو أخرت, لو صنعت, لو ما فعلت كذا لكان كذا. نعم.
So you got a person who's extremely angry with himself or sorry with himself, and he says, if only I had done this back then this wouldn't have happened, or this would have happened. If only I had done this thing earlier or later or did this, then such and such would happen.
يعني يندم على الأشياء التي حدثت.
That he is apologetic or sorrowful over all those things that have happened previously, or angry with himself for those things which happened previously.
وهذا محرم.
And again, this is محرم, حرام.
ماذا يقول؟
So what should he say instead?
قدر الله وما شاء فعل. يعني هذا الذي قدر وكتب الله سبحانه وتعالى عليه ولله أن يفعل ما شاء وأنا عبد ليس لي إلا الرضا والتسليم ما أندم.
So a person should instead say قدر الله ما شاء فعل, that this is the decree of Allah and whatever He willed it happened. So he's saying that I am the abd, the servant of Allah, and whatever Allah decrees and this happens to me and I am pleased with this.
وهذا كذلك محرم. الاستعمال الرابع كذلك محرم أن يحتج بالقضاء والقدر على المعائب. يعني مثلا يقول إنسان يشرب الخمر نسأل العافية والسلام, تقول له لماذا تشرب الخمر؟ يقول لو شاء الله ما شربت الخمر, أنا أشرب الخمر بقضاء الله وقدره.
And then the other instance of a person using low, if only, and this phrase, and against this is forbidden, is when a person uses this as an excuse to disobey Allah. So for example, there's a person and he drinks alcohol and we ask Allah to protect us. And you go to him and you say, look, why are you drinking alcohol? And he says, look, if only Allah had willed for me not to drink alcohol, then I wouldn't have done so. So this person, what should you do to him or with him? That you hit this person, you beat this person until he becomes unconscious. So once he wakes up, and he says to you, why did you hit me? You say to him, look, if Allah had willed, I wouldn't have hit you.
وترك شرب الخمر والاحتجاج بالقضاء والقدر على المعاصي تتركه وإلا تضرب مرة أخرى.
So if he now stops disobeying Allah, drinking alcohol and using this excuse of if only Allah had willed as an excuse, if he stops doing this, then no problem. But if he carries on using this excuse, you hit him again until he is conscious and you repeat, the cycle repeats.
هذا ليس إلا من باب تبين هذه المسألة لا أحد يضرب أحد يا أخواني. نعم.
So Sheikh said, look, I'm not encouraging you to go out and stop beating people up and hit people up. I'm just giving you an example to clarify this issue.
رفع سارق إلى أمير المؤمنين عمر رضي الله عنه وقضى بأن تقطع يده نسأل الله عليه وسلم. نعم.
A thief was taken up, or his case was taken up to Umar رضي الله عنه, and a ruling was passed that his hand should be chopped off.
فقال هذا السارق لعمر رضي الله عنه يا أمير المؤمنين أتلومني على شيء كتبه الله علي كتب الله علي إنما سرقت بقضاء الله.
So this thief, he said to Umar رضي الله عنه, O Amir al-Mu'mineen, are you blaming me for something? Are you punishing me for something which Allah has decreed? I only stole because it was the decree of Allah.
فقال له عمر رضي الله عنه.
So Umar رضي الله عنه said to him,
كتب الله أن نقطع يدك تلومنا على شيء كتب الله علينا.
That Allah is the one who decreed for us to now chop off your hand. Are you now going to blame us for the decree of Allah?
احتج عليه بنفس الحجة.
So Umar رضي الله عنه, he used the same evidence against him that he was using.
إذن هذه استعمالات للو أربع استعمالات كلها محرمة.
So now these four instances of using this frame, a phrase low or if only, all of these cases are forbidden.
استعمال في الاعتراض على الشرع.
So we said a person contesting the Sharia.
واعتراض على القضاء والقدر.
And a person contesting the decree of Allah.
تحسر وندم.
And a person being extremely angry or apologetic over something that happened a while ago.
الاحتجاج بالقضاء والقدر على المعائب على المعاصي.
And then a person using this phrase if only in order to use it as an excuse to disobey Allah.
الاستعمال الخامس فيه تفصيل.
And now the fifth instance of using low, if only there's some detail in this.
أن تستعمل low في التمني. لأنه يتمنى. رأى فلان من الناس نسأل الله العافية والسلام. يأخذ أموال ويصنع بها المعاصي. فهو يقول لو لدي مثل فلان لصنعت مثل ما صنع لكن ليس عندي شيء.
So the fifth case is a person using this phrase if only in order to desire something which is haram which other people are doing. As an example, he sees a person and he's very rich, he's wealthy, and he's using this wealth to do things which are haram. So this person says, if only I was as rich as he is, and if only I had the same wealth that he had, then I would do what he is doing.
الثاني يرى إنسان ينفق المال في طاعة الله يقول لو كان لي مثل هذا لا صنعت مثل ما صنع فله في النية مثل نية هذا نعم.
And then the same, then a second instance of this type of saying, if only to desire something which somebody else has, is for example, a person sees another person doing goodness. A person sees another person, he's rich and wealthy, and he's giving his wealth in charity. So he says, if only I had the wealth that this person had, then I would do what he is doing, i.e. I would give in charity and I would do goodness. So therefore, the person here who says, if only, and he desires to be like this person, and do the actions that he is doing, then for him, in his intention, is the same reward as the intention of the person who is doing the action.
فحذر.
So be careful.
تتمنى المعاصي.
So you have to be very careful of ever desiring or wanting to do sins.
أو تتمنى أن تفعل ما يفعل هؤلاء نسأل الله العافية والسلام.
Or to ever desire or want to do those things, those actions which those people do.
نعم. تمر بالعصاة بهؤلاء. تقول الحمد لله الذي عافاني من ابتلاكم به تحمد الله ان الله عافاك تحمد الله على هذا الدين تحمد الله على الهدايه تحمد الله على العقل وهؤلاء لا عقل تحمد الله على العفه تحمد الله على كل شيء نعم.
So if you pass by those people who are disobeying Allah and they are sinning, then what should you do? You praise Allah, you say alhamdulillah, all praises to Allah, the one who saved me from what they are doing. So you praise Allah that he has given you an intelligence and he hasn't given those people an intelligence. You praise Allah for the modesty and how he has covered you and how you are safeguarding yourself. So now we have the sixth instance of using low, if only. And this is something which is permitted.
And تأتي لو من باب الخبر قال عليه الصلاة والسلام لو استقبلت من أمري ما استدبرت ما سقت الهدي لم يقل هذا من باب التحسر أو الندم أو الاعتراض عن قضاء القدر نعم.
Is that you now use this phrase or this expression as mere information, like the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said that if I'd known that which was going to happen I wouldn't have bought the sacrificial animal with me, i.e. in Hajj.
ثم ذكر المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى باب النهي عن سب الريح. تأتي رياح قوية عاصفة والناس يتكلموا على هذه الريح، فالكلام على الريح كالكلام على ما تقدم معنا في الدهر. نعم.
Then the next chapter that the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, mentioned is a person insulting the wind or الجو, the weather. نعم.
نعم.
A person insulting
الريح. الريح. نعم.
A person insulting the wind or bad weather or hurricanes. So when a hurricane comes or stormy winds come, then a person starts speaking against and insulting this. And this is similar to what we mentioned regarding a person insulting the days and the times and the months.
الرياح والعواصف. إذا يعتقد أن هذه الرياح مؤثرة بذاتها هذا شرك أكبر.
So again, if a person now believes that it is the storm and the winds and they are the ones who have the influence in itself, there is influence in them, they themselves bring about the good or the harm, then this is shirk akbar.
إذا يعتقد أن الله سبحانه وتعالى هو الآمر لهذه الريح لكن يسب هذه الريح لأنها محل الشيء الذي لا يحب ويكره فهذا محرم وسفه ونقص في العقل. نعم.
And if a person believes inside him that it is Allah who controls the winds, or Allah brings about the good and the harm, however, he is insulting or lamenting the winds because it was in the instance of the winds and the storms when certain bad things happen, then this is something which is impermissible and it's also a defect in a person's intelligence.
الثالث خبر محض.
And then the third instance is mere information.
وهذا جائز.
And this is permitted.
يقول هذه رياح وعواصف شديدة عاتية قلعت الأشجار وخربت الديار إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون.
So for example, a person says mere information that these winds that are coming or these winds that pass by us, this storm that passed by us, it was very severe, it was very strong, houses were destroyed, trees were removed. وإنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون.
خبر محض صح.
So this is now mere information and this is permissible.
فماذا تقول عند الرياح والعواصف.
So therefore, what should you say when there are severe storms and winds?
تقول الدعاء الوارد عن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
You say the supplication which has been narrated from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
يا أخواننا تأخذ مثلا حسن المسلم أو رسالة من الرسائل الموثوق فيها التي فيها حديث الصحيح عن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام. نعم.
Said, oh, our brothers, you should take this book, The Fortress of the Muslim, in which it contains many du'as, or a book in which you trust mentioning the narrations or the supplications of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam.
عند البدء بالطعام بسم الله.
So, for example, before you start eating food, you say Bismillah in the name of Allah.
وعند الانتهاء تقول تحمد الله سبحانه وتعالى. الحمد لله الذي أطعمني هذا ورزقني من غير حول مني ولا قوة. غير هذا من الأدعية عند الطعام، عند دخول المنزل، عند الخروج، عند هبوب الريح، عند التحسر والندم، قلنا تقول قدر الله وما شاء فعل. وعلى هذا دائما تعتاد على حتى تحفظ هذا الكتاب ثم تضعه في المكتبة. نعم.
So you look at this book, and in all of the various instances, you say and you learn and you memorize the supplications of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So, for example, before eating, you mention the name of Allah, Bismillah. After finishing eating, you praise Allah. You say, "All praise is to the One who gave me this to eat and drink without any power or might from me." And in all these instances, when you go out of your house, when you come in your house, when you wear new clothes, and you keep doing this. And you keep looking at this book and saying these supplications until you have memorized them. Once you have memorized these supplications and you're not in need of this book, then you take the book and you place it in the library.
لأننا إذا لم نأتي بهذه الأذكار المشروعة دخلت علينا الأذكار الغير مشروعة. إذا لم تقل يا الله أو سبحان الله جاءوك بماذا؟ Oh my God. نعم. تقول إن شاء الله. لا تسب الريح فهمت تقول اللهم إني أسألك من خير هذه الريح والدعاء الوارد عن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام مفهوم نعم.
So if we don't now mention these supplications and these narrations which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to mention, then what will happen? We'll start saying those things which are found with the people today. So instead of saying Ya Allah, Allahumma, O Allah, Inshallah, we start saying, "Oh my God," and expressions like this.
ثم بعد هذا أتى المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى بباب الظن بالله. حسن الظن في الله. لابد أن تحسن الظن في الله سبحانه وتعالى. وغير هذا ظن أهل النفاق والشرك نسأل الله عافية السلامة أنهم يسوؤون الظن في الله سبحانه وتعالى. نعم.
And then after this, the author, may Allah have mercy upon him. He brought another chapter regarding the thought that Allah has, the thought that people have of Allah. Meaning that you should always have a good thinking regarding Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a good estimation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and not something which is suspicious or a bad thought about Allah. So that which is a good thinking or a positive thought of Allah, then this is the way of the believers and the Muslims. As for the other thoughts and the suspicion regarding Allah, then this is the way of the people of nifaq, hypocrisy and disbelief.
يحسن الظن في الله سبحانه وتعالى فيما اختص بنفسه. في نفسه يقول والله أن الله سبحانه وتعالى اختار لي كل خير ودفع عني كل شر ولله الحمد.
So firstly, a person regarding himself and his own personal cases and his situation should always have a good thought of Allah. He says, whatever Allah has decreed for me, it's all goodness and only goodness. And all praises for Allah.
وفيما يحسن الظن كذلك في نفسه وفي غيره وفيما يحدث في هذا الكون. أنه كل ما يقدر الله سبحانه وتعالى قدر الله سبحانه وتعالى لحكمة أرادها الله سبحانه وتعالى. نعم.
And also a person should have a good thinking or a positive thinking of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in himself, in the other people around him, and everything that is occurring in the world. That he always says that whatever happens, Allah has decreed out of a wisdom.
الثاني ظن الذين كفروا فويل الذين كفروا من النار أن يظن بالله غير الحق ظن الجاهلية نسأل الله عافية السلام.
And then the third type of thinking about Allah is to have a bad thought of Allah or suspicion of Allah. The thought of the people of disbelief, that they thought about Allah and they estimated Him such, which wasn't correct, which wasn't the truth. And woe be upon the disbelievers for the of the fire.
يقول ابن القيم رحمه الله تعالى.
ابن القيم may Allah have mercy upon him, he says.
إن بعض الناس يظن بنفسه أنه مظلوم.
Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he said that some people, they think regarding themselves that they have been oppressed.
ناقص الحظ.
And that their portion from this world, it is deficient.
يقول ظلمني ربي.
And some people say that my Lord has oppressed me.
ومنعني ما استحق.
And they say that He has prevented me from that which I am deserving of.
ولماذا فلان له وله كذا وكذا من الأولاد والسيارات والأموال وأنا ليس لي شيء. نعم. يقول لماذا فلان له كذا وكذا من الأولاد والأموال وأنا ليس لي شيء.
Some people they say that why is it this person he has this many children, this much wealth and all these things, and I haven't got any of this.
والله أنا أحق بهذا منه.
Says rather I am more deserving of this than that person.
أو فيما اختص بغيري في الناس يعني يقول عندما يمرض هذا أو يعني يحصل له فقد ولد أو مال يقول مسكين ما تستاهل ما تستحق ليس لي من الأمر شيء حتى أصنع لك شيئا. نعم.
And also for example a person says this regarding other people that when somebody is injured or when somebody has an illness he'll say about him, oh مسكين, now such a poor person, this happened to him, he wasn't deserving of this.
أو في هذا الكون يقول لماذا يأتي في هذه الأيام الحرب.
And also regarding that which is happening outside, a person says, why is it that the war has come now?
وهذا كثير وقليل عند بعض الناس.
And with many people, or some people, this is a lot and also a little.
ما هو العلاج؟
So therefore, what is the solution or the cure?
دراسة التوحيد.
Firstly, studying and learning توحيد.
وبخاصة دراسة باب الأسماء والصفات لأن العبد إذا درس باب الأسماء والصفات علم. أن الله رحيم عزيز غفور كريم حكيم يرضى ويسلم يقول كل ما يأتي من الله فهو خير. نعم.
And more so studying this subject, the names and attributes of Allah, because a person who studies the names and attributes of Allah and he knows the description, the qualities of Allah, he knows that Allah is most merciful, Allah is forgiving, Allah is mighty, Allah is powerful. So he always has a good thought of Allah. Everything is done with the decree and the wisdom of Allah.
تعتني بهذا الباب عناية خاصة.
So you should attach importance to this subject more than anything else.
تتوب إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى من ظن السوء.
You repent to Allah from having a bad thought or a bad suspicion about Him.
تستغفر.
You seek forgiveness.
تظن بنفسك السوء.
So you think regarding yourself something which is bad.
ليس فيها خير.
And there is nothing good in it.
وقل يقول ابن القيم وقل يا نفس مأوى كل سوء النفس مأوى كل سوء. نعم.
And Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah says that a person should say that my own desires it should only lead to every type of evil.
أترجو الخير من ميت بخيل. هل ترجو الخير من ميت وبخيل.
That do you seek goodness, do you ask for goodness from somebody who is deceased and somebody who is stingy.
تقول أنا ميت وبخيل.
So a person should say عن نفسه.
نعم.
A person should say regarding himself that I am dead, I am stingy.
ومقصر.
And I am deficient.
ومذنب.
And I am a sinner.
وكل ما بك من تقوى وصلاح واستقامة وهداية فهي من الله سبحانه منك.
And everything that you have in terms of practicing the religion of Allah and taqwa, and being upright upon the religion of Allah, then this isn't from you, rather this is all from Allah.
يقول,
he says,
وَظُنَّ بِنَفْسِكَ السُّوءَ.
So always think regarding yourself something which is bad.
نفس أمارة بالسوء.
Because the soul is full of desires and evil.
إِذَا ظَنَنْتْ بِهَا هَذَا تَجِدْهَا يَقُلْ تَمْشِي عَلَى الصِّرَاطِ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ.
If you always have this approach regarding yourself, you'll find yourself remaining upon the straight path.
وَظُنَّ بِنَفْسِكَ السُّوءَ تَجِدْهَا كَذَاكَ يعني تمشي على الصراط المستقيم. وَخَيْرُهَا كَالْمُسْتَحِيلِ يقول ليس فيها خير مستحيل أن يأتي منك خير أبد.
And you always think that as long as I stay upon this approach I will stay on the right path. And you never think that this goodness is from me. There's no goodness in you yourself.
كل ما بها من خير فهو من الله.
Every type of goodness that you have, then it's from Allah.
فتلك مواهب الرب الجليل سبحانه وتعالى.
So these are
هبات الله سبحانه وتعالى عطاء الله.
So these are the blessings of Allah which He bestows, Ar-Rahman, the Most Merciful.
ثم ذكر المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى باب ما جاء في كفر أي الكفر الأكبر في من أنكر القضاء والقدر صلى الله عليه وسلم. لأن الإيمان بالقضاء والقدر ركن من أركان الإيمان الستة. نعم.
And then after this, the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, he mentioned the next chapter, which was regarding the major form of kufr. One of the most major forms of kufr is a person denying the qadr, the decree of Allah. Why? Because the decree of Allah, the qadr of Allah, it is one of the six pillars of iman, and therefore denying it is kufr akbar.
ذكرنا فيما تقدم في شرح الأصول الثلاثة شرح أركان الإيمان وتعريف الإيمان عند أهل السنة والجماعة.
That we meant.
ذكرنا فيما تقدم في شرح الأصول الثلاثة شرح أركان الإيمان الستة وتعرفنا الإيمان عند أهل السنة والجماعة.
So we have mentioned previously in previous lessons, for example, in explaining the three fundamental principles, the book, or explaining the six pillars of al-Iman and the statement of the Ahlus Sunnah regarding it.
وذكرنا أن الإيمان بالقضاء والقدر له أربع مراتب لا بد من تحقيقها.
So we mentioned previously that a person having Iman in the decree of Allah, it is of four levels, and each of these four levels have to be fulfilled.
المرتبة الأولى العلم أن تؤمن أن الله سبحانه وتعالى علم كل شيء.
So the first level of affirming decree in Allah is العلم, knowledge, meaning that you affirm and you believe that Allah had knowledge of everything before it was decreed.
الثاني أن الله سبحانه وتعالى أمر القلم بأن يكتب مقادير كل شيء إلى أن تقوم الساعة.
And then the second level of belief that you have to fulfill is that you believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He ordered the pen to write everything which will occur and happen and all the details up until the establishment of the hour.
الثالث المشيئة أن للعبد مشيئة وإرادة واختيار لكن تحت مشيئة الله فما شاء الله كان وما لم يشأ لم يكن وما تشاءون إلا أن يشاء الله رب العالمين.
And then the third aspect of decree that you have to believe in is that you believe in a will, i.e. that the slaves, human beings, the people, they also have a will. They can choose to do this or that, wrong or right, but their will is under the will of Allah. So whatever Allah wills happens, and whatever Allah does not will not happen. And as Allah said in the Quran, and they do not will anything except it is under the will of Allah, رب العالمين, the Lord of the worlds.
الرابع أن العبد مخلوق وأعماله تابعة له فهي مخلوقة والله خلقكم وما تعملون. نعم.
And then the fourth aspect of al-Iman bil-Qadr is believing that just as creation are created, just as the humans are created, then also the actions which people do have also been created. And Allah said in the Quran that He is the one who created you and your actions.
ثم أورد المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى باب ما جاء في المصورين أي في النهي عن التصوير وأن التصوير كبيرة من كبائر الذنوب. نعم.
كيف ترجم التصوير؟
تصوير
جعل الصورة
picture. سنأتي بأمثلة الآن.
طيب. So then the next chapter that the author رحمه الله mentioned is regarding what has been narrated regarding the مصورين, loosely translated as those people who make or create pictures or images.
ما علاقة التصوير بالتوحيد؟
So what is the link or the relationship between a person making or creating or taking pictures and images and التوحيد؟
أول شرك حدث في الأرض بفتنة التصاوير والتماثيل.
So the first shirk, the first instance of shirk which occurred in this ummah was due to this issue, the issue of making or taking pictures or images and making statues.
والتصوير خلق وإبداع فهو مضاهاة لخلق الله يعني تحدي لله سبحانه وتعالى كأنه هذا يريد أن يخلق مثل ما خلق الله سبحانه وتعالى.
So in a person making or creating or taking images and pictures, it's as if a person is contesting and competing with the creation of Allah.
التصوير الفوتوغرافي بالكاميرا.
So photographic images, taking pictures using cameras.
يصور الأشجار والبحار والأنهار. هذا لا إشكال فيه.
A person, he can take photographs of and he can capture images of trees, oceans, places. And there's nothing wrong with this.
يصور اللصوص والمجرمين حتى يحذر منهم الحكومات.
And also the action of taking a picture of people who are criminals, thieves, for example, in order to protect the people.
الصورة في البطاقة الشخصية وجواز السفر.
So there is nothing wrong with this. Also, a person, for example, taking a photograph of himself in order for his passport or ID.
ضرورة لا إشكال فيها.
So this is now a necessity, and there is nothing wrong with it.
يصور الزوجة والأولاد والوالدة حتى يعني يتذكر هؤلاء من باب الحنان. ما أدري كيف تفسر.
A person, for example, taking an image or taking a photographical image of his wife, his children, his family, so he can remember them and love them and cherish them.
حرام.
This is impermissible.
هذا أنا ما أقول هذا. هذا كلام الشيخ بن عثيمين رحمه الله.
So this isn't something which I am saying. This is the statement of Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen رحمه الله.
يصور العلماء والعظماء ويصور والده والجد وجد الجد حتى يتذكر ما كانوا عليه من وعظ وصلاح وتقوى. فعل قوم نوح عليه الصلاة والسلام يؤدي للشرك الأكبر.
And then a person taking pictures with his with cameras of the great people or the scholars or his father or his grandfather who used to do righteous actions, and his intention in doing this is to remember the great actions of these people that they used to do, the piety of the scholars or the righteous people. This is the action of the people of Nuh alayhi salam, and it only led them to a shirk.
تصوير الفيديو للدروس والمحاضرات.
As for video recordings of lessons and lectures,
يذكر الشيخ بن عثيمين رحمه الله تعالى أن هذا جائز لأنه يؤدي إلى نفع الأمة. نعم.
And then Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen رحمه الله, he mentions regarding this, regarding video recording of lessons and lectures, that this is permitted. Why? Because it leads to the benefit of the Ummah and the spreading of knowledge.
تصوير النساء.
As for taking pictures of women,
للنظر نسأل الله عافية السلامة إلى المنكرات والمحرمات.
In order to look into it and look into evil and those things which are prohibited.
وهذا محرم.
Then this is haram. This is forbidden.
يا أخوان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال دع ما ريبك لما لا ريب.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, leave off that which causes you to doubt, for that which there is no doubt in it.
أترك التصوير وارتاح.
Leave off taking pictures of people with the cameras and you can relax.
إلا إذا كان للمحاضرات والدروس أو للضرورة جواز السفر وبطاقة الشخصية.
Unless it is video recordings of lessons and lectures or something which is a necessity like your ID or passport.
نعم. لأن عقوبة المصور نسأل الله العافية والسلامة خمسة.
Because
خمس عقوبات للمصور.
Because the punishment of a person who
تعال عندنا هنا أحسن حل. نعم عقوبة المصور خمس عقوبات, واحدة منها تكفي في أن تجعل التصوير كبيرة من كبائر الذنوب.
Because the punishment of taking images or making images or creating images, there are five different punishments that have been mentioned. One of these punishments is enough for this to be considered as a major sin.
ملعون.
That this person, he is cursed.
وفي النار.
And he's in the fire.
أشد الناس أو من أشد الناس عقوبة يوم القيامة.
Rather, he will be from the most severe of people, will be punished with the severest of punishments.
يكلف أن ينفخ فيها الروح وليس بنافخ.
And then he is ordered to blow into it a soul, and he is able to do so.
يجعل له بكل صورة صورها نفس يعذب بها المصور يوم القيامة.
And then, for every image that he has taken or picture he has made, with a person with a, of a being with a soul in it, then this image he's punished due to it.
إذن ابتعد عن التصوير واستريح.
And therefore a person should stay away from taking pictures and making images, and he's easy and relaxed.
وكم حدث من إشكالات في التصوير ونشر على مواقع انترنت وكذا, وقال بعض الناس والله صورت فلان وهو واقف مع فلان او كذا او كذا او كذا.
And how many problems have occurred because of these images and photos that have been taken then spread on the internet, somebody saying I saw this person, I took a photograph of this man with this woman and this and this.
حتى الان يعني يستطيع ان يجعل ابو العباس يعني يصنع له فيلم كامل يمثل فيه. صحيح والله يأخذ فقط الوجه ويضعه ويصنع به كل شيء. نعم.
So nowadays a person is able to take, for example, Sheikh Haytham and take his face and make him do all sorts of actions just by taking his face and photographing it into something else.
المهم أخواننا لابد أيضا أن نحسن الظن أخواننا, لا نسيء الظن. فعندما ترى الآن عندما ينشر بعض الناس بعض الصور وكذا, أن تحسن الظن, لا تسيء الظن, مفهوم؟ إيه نعم.
And also, we have.
لأن المسلم الأصل فيه أن يحسن الظن, لا يسيء الظن.
And also, as Muslims, we always have to make excuses and have a good thought about other people and other Muslims. So, for example, if you see a photo of somebody in a particular situation, then you don't straight away become suspicious and have bad thoughts of that person. Rather, the asl with the Muslim. Is the origin with a Muslim is that we have good thoughts and you know we make excuses for people.
لأنك لا تستطيع مثلا أن تقذف إنسان وحدك, لابد من شهود أربعة ويشهدوا على الزمان والمكان ويروا نسأل الله السلامة الفاحشة 100%. فاليوم عندنا بهذه الوسائل أصبح لا أعراض ولا حقوق للآخرين. نعم. ممن يدعي الإسلام. نعم.
So it's not permitted for a person to accuse another person of an act of indecency except with four witnesses, and these four witnesses they have to take an oath regarding the time and the place, and then these four witnesses, every single one of them, have to actually see themselves independently the act of indecency or adultery. Nowadays with these videos and these photographs, people are being accused of all sorts of things.
خرج أحد العلماء إلى دولة من الدول وأقام فيها دورة علمية.
One of the scholars, he left a particular country and went to another country in order for a conference.
ويعني نزل في هذه الدولة على يعني نفقة هذه الدولة في فندق يعني من الفنادق الكبيرة جدا.
And then he stayed or he was accommodated in a particular hotel from the big famous hotels, and this was the cost, you know, was paid by the country.
انتهت الدورة ورجع الشيخ إلى المملكة ولله الحمد. فجاء هذا الأخ من لجنة الدورة أراد أن يدفع قيمة يعني إيجار الفندق. نعم.
So then this sheikh, he finished his conference, he went back to his country, he went back to Saudi Arabia, and then the person who was in the committee of organizing this conference, he came to the sheikh and he said, give me the bill of the hotel so I can pay it.
فأخرجوا له فاتورة يعني مرتفعة الثمر جدا, يعني كثيرة جدا. نعم.
So then the hotel bill, it came and it was extremely expensive.
قال لماذا هي مرتفعة بهذا الحد؟
قال الشيخ
لا, هذا الأخ الشيخ ذهب إلى السعودية.
So then the person who was going to pay the hotel bill, he said, why is this bill so expensive?
قالوا له هذا الشيخ يتناول في كل يوم من خمس إلى ست قوارير خمر.
And the people in the hotel, they said that this sheikh that you've called, that he is drinking alcohol, he's drinking bottles and bottles of alcohol.
من خمسة إلى ستة قوارير في اليوم.
5 to 6 bottles every single day.
الآن كل واحد من يسمع هذا الكلام يقول أعوذ بالله.
So now every person hears this speech says أعوذ بالله.
هل هذا شيخ؟
Is this, can this be a sheikh?
فهذا الأخ قال والله ما يمكن أدفع قيمة خمر.
So then this person says, look, it's not possible for me to now give pay the expenses of the alcohol.
وهذا شيخ؟
And this is a sheikh.
ما يمكن.
It's not possible that the sheikh would do this.
المهم غاضب ماذا يصنع؟
So he became angry and what did he say to them?
قال أنا الآن أتصل على هذا الشيخ وأصنع به ما أصنع ما ولا علي.
He says right now I'm going to ring this sheikh and I'm going to deal with him.
فلا سلام.
So he rings him. He doesn't give him salam.
ولا قال له يا شيخ.
He doesn't say oh sheikh.
ولا غيره.
And nothing else.
قال هؤلاء في الفندق.
He says those people in the hotel.
أخرجوا فاتورة فيها من ست إلى خمس قوارب.
They've just given me a receipt which contains 5 to 6 bottles of alcohol every day.
وأراد أن أدفع وأنا والله ما أدفع قيمة الخمر.
And they want me to now pay the price and the expenses and I'm not going to pay for alcohol.
تصرف أنت.
So you go pay for it.
فقال الشيخ قال سبحان الله أنا في كل يوم عندما آتي للفندق. أفتح الثلاجة أجد في هذه القوارير أكسرها وهو يظن أن هذه القوارير ضمن الفندق ولا يدري أن لها حساب غير الفندق غير الغرفة.
So the sheikh says Subhanallah, I come into my room and I find the fridge. I open the fridge and there's bottles of alcohol there. So when I find these bottles of alcohol, I take them, I smash them and I throw them away. And this sheikh he thought that this is including the price of the hotel.
ثم أنا لو أتناول في كل يوم من 5 إلى 6 قوارب كيف أؤدي لكم الدواء أصلاً؟
And then the sheikh says that if I'm drinking 5 to 6 bottles of alcohol every single day, then how am I possibly coming to you and giving you this conference and lectures؟
يا أخوانا عندما سمع بيت من بيوت الأنصار الكلام في أم المؤمنين عائشة رضي الله عنها.
When a house from the, amongst the houses of the Ansar in Medina, when they heard some speech against Umm al-Mu'minin Aisha radiallahu anha,
قال لزوجته,
then the husband he said to his wife from the Ansar, he said to his wife,
نحن نعتقد أن الله سبحانه وتعالى اختار للنبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم خيرة النساء ونحن نعتقد أن أم المؤمنين أفضل منا.
The man said to his wife, the Ansari said to his wife, that we believe, our aqeedah is, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has chosen for our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best of women. Rather, we believe that these women, the mothers of the believers, they are better and more virtuous than us.
ونحن لا نصنع هذا الشيء نحن. فكيف يصنع من هو أفضل منا؟ ولو كان هذا وقع من أم المؤمنين عائشة فهو واقع منا ونحن ننزه أنفسنا عن هذا إذا والله لابد أن ننزه أم المؤمنين عائشة رضي الله عنها. هذا هو صنيع السلف الصالح رضي الله عليهم أخواننا حسن الظن اليوم حدث ولا حرج. نعم.
So this man he said to his wife that we believe that Allah has chosen Aisha radiallahu anha for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we believe that she's the best of the women. And we believe that she's better than us. And this thing or this rumor that we are hearing, it's not possible that this would come from Aisha radiallahu anha. Why? Because she's better than us. So if this thing is happening from Aisha radiallahu anha, then no doubt it must have occurred from us before. And because we are freeing ourselves from this, and we would never do this, then there's absolutely no way that this rumor could be true about Aisha radiallahu anha. So this was the good thought and the making of excuses and the thinking of the Sahaba and the Salaf. As for nowadays, the rumors are being spread and the evil thoughts then speak and there's no limit.
كل شيء اليوم بعد ثواني تجده في الانترنت.
So nowadays, anything after a few seconds, you find it on the internet.
أشياء تصنعها وأشياء ما تصنعها. كل شيء موجود.
Some things that you might have done and other things you've never done and it's all on the internet.
لو أراد أن يجعلوك نسأل الله عافية السلامة يعني في الحضيض جعلك في الحضيض. أراد أن يرفعوك رفعوك.
So if these people, if they want you to make somebody belittled and low and humiliated, they could do so. And if they want you to raise you up, they could do so.
هل بهذا جاءت الشريعة؟
So did the Sharia come with these things?
الله أعلم. ثم أورد المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى باب ما جاء في كثرة الحلف يعني يكثر من الحلف بالله. نعم.
And then after this, the author رحمه الله he mentioned the next chapter regarding a person taking oaths and vows a lot.
كثرة الحلف تدل أن ليس في قلب الحالف شيء من تعظيم الله، لأن تعظيم الله سبحانه وتعالى يقتضي الهيبة والخوف من الحلف بالله سبحانه وتعالى. ولهذا ألف بعض العلماء رحمه الله تعالى في كتاب مؤلف في أيمان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم، هذا دليل أنها قليلة. نعم.
So a person always taking a vow by Allah, meaning always saying by Allah, wallahi, wallahi, and saying this all the time, then this shows that there is a lack of respect or a lack of honor and exalting of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because if you had this respect and this honor and this exalting of Allah, then it wouldn't be something that you just mention all the time so easily. That's al ulama.
ألف بعض العلماء رحمهم الله تعالى كتابا في أيمان النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام، هذا دليل أنها قليلة معدودة. نعم.
Some of the ulama, they wrote a book or an article regarding the instances in which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made a vow, took an oath, or said by Allah. This therefore shows that the fact they can actually enumerate them and limit them, that there were very very few instances.
فمراتب حفظ اليمين أربعة.
So therefore, the levels of a person fulfilling his vow are four.
ابتداءً بِأَلَّا نَحْلِف.
So firstly, a person shouldn't take a vow in the first place.
وَوَسَطًا بِأَنَّ الْإِنسَانِ إِذَا حَلَف يَفِي.
And then, if a person does take a vow or an oath to do something by Allah, then he has to fulfill it and complete it.
وَانْتِهَاءً إِذَا لَمْ يَفِي يُكَفِّر فَإِخْرَاج الْكَفَّارَ دَلِيل عَلَى حِفْظِ الْيَمِينِ.
And then if a person, after making the vow, he doesn't fulfill the vow and he doesn't complete the oath, then he has to give the expiation. And by a person fulfilling and giving the expiation, this shows that he attaches importance to his vow and his oath.
الرابع ألا يحلف إلا بالله. يحفظ اليمين بألا يحلف إلا بالله.
And then fourthly, a person should never take a vow or an oath except by Allah.
نعم. هذه مراتب حفظ اليمين الأربعة. نعم.
So these are the four levels of a person protecting and preserving his vows and his oaths.
ثم ذكر المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى باب ما جاء في أن الله سبحانه وتعالى أخذ العهد على العباد أن يعبدوه ولا يشركوا به شيئا. ولا بد أن نفي بهذا العهد. نعم.
And then after this, the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, he mentioned in the next chapter that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he made the people, he made them responsible, or he took from them a pledge that they should worship him. And therefore, we have to fulfill our responsibilities and our pledge.
ثم أورد باب خطير جدا وهو التألي، أي أن هذا العبد يحكم على الله سبحانه وتعالى بأن لا يغفر لفلان، يعني يتألى يتعاظم على الله، يقول والله لا يغفر الله لفلان. غفر الذنب بيد من؟ بيد الله سبحانه وتعالى. فهؤلاء مثلا عندنا أئمة الكفر الآن، لو تاب الواحد منهم تاب الله عليه، وتسمع بعض الناس يقول والله لا يغفر الله لفلان. نعم.
And then the next chapter the author mentioned is something which is very serious, and this is a person contesting with Allah or being certain that Allah will not forgive a certain person, as if he himself, he is in control and over the ruling of Allah by saying, by Allah, Allah will not forgive you or Allah will not forgive his sin. Those people now, the leaders of disbelief, Allah can forgive them. And this person, you hear people saying nowadays that Allah will never forgive this type of person.
عدم جعل المخلوق أعلى من رتبة الخالق، يعني بعض الناس يجعل رتبة المخلوق أعلى من رتبة الخالق سبحانه وتعالى. نعم.
And then the author رحمه الله, he mentioned another chapter, and that is that we don't give superiority or more preference to creation over the creator.
ثم في نهاية هذا القسم ذكر أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لم يحمي التوحيد فقط، حمى حمى التوحيد، كأنه جعل للتوحيد سور وأخذ يحمي السور حتى لا يقع أحد في السور فضل أن يقع في التوحيد، أغلق كل طريق يوصل إلى الشرك، أشياء محرمة لأنها تؤدي للشرك الأصغر. الشرك الأصغر لأنه يؤدي للأكبر. نعم.
And then after this, the author, rahimullah, he mentioned the next chapter, and he finished the ninth section of the book with a chapter that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, not only did he protect Tawheed itself, but he protected everything around At-Tawheed. It's as if the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he built a wall around At-Tawheed and then protected the wall. So he closed every single avenue which might possibly lead to a shirk. So he warned against those matters which are haram, they are sins, because they might lead to shirk asghar, minor form of shirk. And he warned and protected against shirk al-asghar because maybe it will eventually lead to and be an avenue towards a shirk al-akbar.
فالمراتب أربعة.
So therefore there are four levels.
صغائر.
Four levels of sins or things which are impermissible. The minor sins.
وأعلى من الصغائر كبائر.
And then higher than the minor sins or the major sins.
ثم شرك أصغر أعلى من الكبائر.
And then more severe than the major sins is minor form of shirk, shirk al-asghar.
وأعلى من الشرك الأصغر الشرك الأكبر. نسأل الله العافية والسلام.
And then that which is more severe than the minor form of shirk is major form of shirk, and we ask Allah for safety.
صغائر. صغائر.
Minor sins.
وهذا كل محرم.
So the minor sins is everything which is haram.
الكبائر كل ما رتب عليه عقوبة خاصة.
And then a major sin, the definition of a major sin is something which has a specific punishment to it.
لعن.
Like a curse.
أو طرد.
Or for example.
أو غضب.
Or anger of Allah.
أو عقوبة خاصة في الدنيا أو في الآخرة.
Or a specific punishment in this world for a specific sin. Or a specific punishment in the hereafter for a specific sin.
أو شبه بعقبة الحيوانات.
Or for example, a person due to this sin, he has been likened to the animals.
أو بأنهم من المشركين من المنافقين من الكافرين.
Or that a person does a particular sin, then the particular punishment is that it is resembling the mushrikeen or the munafiqeen or the disbelievers.
أو ليس من المؤمنين.
Or a person says, or that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that a believer is not one who does such an action, then this is now a major sin.
أو من أتباع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Or that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said that the one who does a particular sin is not from my followers, this sin now is a major sin.
كل ما رتب عليه عقوبة خاصة فهو كبيرة.
So therefore, every sin which has a specific punishment, then this now becomes a major sin.
فالكبائر ليست معدودة، لا نستطيع أن نعد الكبائر كما نعد أركان الإسلام والإيمان، فهي محدودة بحد هذا الذي ذكرناه، كل ما رتب عليه عقوبة خاصة.
So therefore we can't limit or enumerate the major sins. We can't say that the major sins are 5 or 6 or 10 like we do with the pillars of Iman and the pillars of Islam. We say 5 pillars of Islam and 6 pillars of Iman. Rather, we say that the definition of a major sin is that which we have mentioned. These definitions or these restrictions.
والإمام الذهبي رحمه الله تعالى في كتابه الكبائر لم يدعي حصر الكبائر لكن ذكر منها.
And as for Imam al-Dhahabi رحمه الله in his book Al-Kabair, the major sins, then he never claimed that which he has mentioned, these are only the major sins. Rather, he said that from amongst the major sins are those which I have mentioned. Meaning there are other major sins.
هل الكبائر أكبر من الشرك الأصغر؟
Are the major sins more severe and greater than minor shirk?
لا. No. الشرك الأصغر أكبر من الكبائر.
So minor shirk, الشرك الأصغر is greater and more severe than the major sins.
هل تكفر بالعمل الصالح أو لا بد لها من توبة؟
الكبائر.
نعم.
Are the major sins expiated by a person doing good deeds? Are the major sins naturally forgiven and expiated, or does a person have to have a specific repentance and a specific forgiveness for that major sin?
الأحوط أن لا بد لها من توبة.
That which is safer is that we say that every major sin that a person does, then he has to make a specific repentance or seek forgiveness.
فاعل الكبيرة هل هو كافر كفر أكبر أو مؤمن كامل الإيمان؟
So a person who commits major sins, is he now a disbeliever, or do we say that he is a person who has complete iman?
مؤمن ناقص الإيمان أو مؤمن بإيمان فاسق بكبيرته.
We say regarding this person that he is a believer, he is a mu'min, however his believer, his iman is deficient. Or we say regarding him that he is a believer with his iman and he is a fasiq, he is a sinner or disobedient according to this major sin.
هل يحب أو يبغى فعل كبيرة؟
The person who commits major sins, is he to be loved or is he to be hated?
يحب بما فيه من إيمان ويبغض بما فيه من فسق ومعاصي وكبائر.
So he is loved according to the level of his iman and righteousness, and he is hated according to his level of sinning and disobedience.
ولا يجالس حال ارتكابه للكبيرة.
And he should not be accompanied or sat with whilst he is committing that action.
هل يصح التوبة من بعض الكبائر دون البعض الآخر أو لا بد أن يتوب من الجميع؟
Is it permissible?
يعني لديه نسأل الله العافية والسلامة ثلاث كبائر: غيبة وسرقة وكذب.
An example: a person has three major sins. He's committed three major sins: الغيبة, backbiting, stealing, and نميمة, slandering.
قال أتوب من السرقة ومن الكذب، لكن الغيبة لا يمكن أن أتوب منها.
So a person, for example, he says that I seek forgiveness and repentance from stealing. I seek forgiveness and repentance from slandering. But as for backbiting, I don't seek repentance. I don't repent from it.
يصح التوبة من بعضها مع الإرشاد أنه لابد أن يتوب من الجميع. ويخفف عن نفسه. نسأل الله عليه السلام. نعم.
So we say that this is permitted, but at the same time we advise him and we direct him to seek forgiveness for all of his acts of major sins.
هذا ما يتعلق بالكبائر.
So this is what relates to the second type of haram actions, which are the major sins.
الشرك الأكبر والشرك الأصغر.
As for the major form of shirk and the minor form of shirk.
الشرك الأكبر مخرج من الملة، الأصغر غير مخرج من الملة.
الشرك الأكبر, the major form of shirk, it takes a person outside the fold of Islam. It makes him become a disbeliever. As for the minor form of shirk, then it doesn't.
مبيح للدم والمال من السلطان الأكبر. والأصغر غير مبيح للدم والمال من السلطان.
The major form of shirk, it permits the blood and the wealth of this person who has now disbelieved. And this is from the ruler and the leader. As for the minor form of shirk, then it doesn't permit this.
محبط لكل الأعمال الأكبر والأصغر محبط للعمل الخاص.
So major shirk, it destroys and makes and corrupts all of a person's previous actions. As for the minor shirk, then it only corrupts or destroys those specific actions.
مخلد خلود أبدي في النار إذا مات عليه نسأل الله عافية والسلامة على الشرك الأكبر. غير مخلد خلود أبدي في النار إذا كان على الشرك الأصغر يعذب بقدر الشرك ثم يدخل الجنة.
The major form of shirk.
أكبر.
Yeah, the major form of shirk. If a person enters into the fire and he dies upon this without making tawbah, without seeking repentance, then he remains in Jahannam forever. As for, and we ask Allah's safety. As for the minor form of shirk, then he may enter into Jannah, into Jahannam, and then he will be removed from it after a time.
كل من اعتقد أن لأحد دون الله تصرف خفي في الكون أو بيده جلب المنافع أو دفع المضار فهذا أكبر.
So every person who believes that somebody else has control over the affairs or somebody else possesses the ability to benefit or harm, then this is shirk al-akbar.
وإذا اعتقد ما لم يجعل الله سبحانه وتعالى سبب سببا فهذا شرك أصغر.
But if a person believes that Allah has made something as a means or a cause and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't make that thing as a means or a cause, then this is shirk al-asghar. وضح بالمثال.
مثال قلنا يضع رأس الثور، إذا اعتقد أن رأس الثور هو المؤثر بذاته فهذا أكبر، واعتقد أنه سبب فهذا أصغر.
So for example, let's say a person, he places the head of a bull or a ram on his house. If he believes that Allah has made this head or this amulet, for example, or this ta'weeth, for example, any example, that this is something which is a reason and a cause and an avenue which Allah has made for protection, and we know that it isn't, then this is shirk asghar. If, however, the person believes that that amulet or that head of the bull in itself protects or harms, then this now becomes shirk akbar.
أن يأتي في نصوص الكتاب والسنة تسمية هذا إما أكبر أو أصغر.
And also one of the ways to distinguish between shirk asghar and shirk akbar is we look into the texts of the Quran and the Sunnah. If we find in the Quran something being mentioned as shirk akbar, then it is shirk akbar and vice versa.
كل ما كان وسيلة إلى الأكبر فهو أصغر.
So everything, every act which is an avenue towards shirk al-akbar, then this action itself becomes shirk asghar.
كل ما أطلق قاعدة للشيخ الإسلام كل ما أطلق الشرع عليه أنه شرك أو كفر دون أن يعرف بألف فهو أصغر. So بين الرجل وبين الشرك والكفر عرف بألف فهو أكبر. اثنتان في الناس هما بهم كفر هذا أصغر. نعم.
And then Shaykh Islam Ibn Taymiyyah رحمه الله, he has a principle.
كل ما أطلق الشرع عليه أنه شرك أو كفر ولم يعرف بألف فهو أصغر.
So everything which comes in the Sharia is described in the Sharia as being shirk. However, alif and lam, al is not mentioned. Meaning, in the Sharia we find a hadith where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, between a man and between his al-kufr and al-shirk, between the shirk and the kufr, this therefore means that this is the major shirk and major kufr.
Akbar.
Major. Now. Also, but in other hadith and other texts, we find kufr and shirk mentioned without alif lam, i.e. without being restricted or specified. For example, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, two characteristics are from shirk kufr, without saying al-shirk or al-kufr. Therefore, this now becomes a minor form of shirk and a minor form of kufr.
على اعتبار لا بد أن الإنسان يحذر من الشرك الأكبر والشرك الأصغر والكبائر والصغائر. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يغفر لي ولكم وأن يجنبنا الشرك والكبائر والصغائر يا رب العالمين. نعم.
In all cases, a person has to totally avoid whether it's these actions, whether it's shirk akbar or asghar or a minor sin or a major sin, and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He forgives me and He forgives you and He helps us avoid these matters.
في القديم كان الكفار يسمون المعبودات آلهة, وفي العصر الحاضر يسمى المعبودات أي ما يقصد من دون الله عند الحوائج سادة. في القديم كانوا يعتقدوا في هذه الآلهة أنها تخلق وترزق.
في القديم
نعم, عندما يسموا هذه آلهة هل يعتقدوا أنها تخلق وترزق؟
So in the previous days when people used to take idols or deities or false gods, did they ever believe that these false gods and these deities themselves, they create and they sustain and they provide?
لا يعتقد فيها جلب المنافع ودفع المضار تقصد عند الحوائج صحيح لا تخلق ولا ترزق. نعم.
They never used to believe that these idols and these false deities themselves, they benefit or they harm or they possess any of this.
في العصر الحاضر غيروا اسم إله إلى اسم سيد, سيد التجاني والسيد البدوي, أي الذي يقصد عند الحوائج, بمعنى إله عند الكفار الذين بعث فيهم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. هذا يقول محمد بن عبد الوهاب رحمه الله.
And nowadays, in the olden days, that which was called as idols or deities and they were given these names, آلهة أو إله, nowadays the people have come in the modern days and they've changed the wording, just changed the wording. So instead of saying the god or the idol Tijani or the god or the idol Al-Ghawth or the god or the idol Al-Badawi, they just say a Sayyid Al-Tijani, i.e. the master or the chief or a Sayyid Al-Badawi.
الذي يقصد عند الحواج, معنى سيد الذي يقصد عند الحواج.
And what they mean by a Sayyid, i.e. a Sayyid Al-Badawi or Tijani, i.e. the person who you should go to when you are in times of difficulty.
النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عندما قالوا له أنت سيدنا, وهو عليه الصلاة والسلام بحق سيد ولد آدم, نهاهم عن هذا وقال السيد الله تبارك وتعالى, أغلق كل طريق يوصل إلى الشرك. نعم.
When the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, when the people came to him and they said to him أنت سيدنا, you are our سيد, meaning أنت خيارنا وأفضلنا, بهذا المعنى السيد.
السيد عند المتأخرين الذي يقصد عند الحوائج, فحتى لا يتوهم هؤلاء عن أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم له شيء من خصائص الربوبية أغلق هذا الباب وقال السيد الله تبارك وتعالى الذي كمل في سؤدده كمل في ربوبيته في ألوهيته في أسماء وصفاته بالنسبة لله سبحانه وتعالى.
So when the companions or when the people came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you said they said anta sayyiduna, meaning you are our chief, you're the best one, the most virtuous amongst us. And no doubt the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the most deserving of this title from amongst the people, the children of Adam. However, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam straight away he closed any avenue that might lead to shirk and a deficiency in tawhid. Rather, he said that Allah, He is the Sayyid. Allah, He is your Sayyid. And this is because
كَمُلَ فِي سُعْدَدِ فِي رُبُوبِيَّةِ فِي أُلُوهِيَّةِ فِي أَسْمَاءِ وَصِفَاتِ.
And Allah is the one who has truly mastered and is perfect in everything in terms of His attributes of رُبُوبِيَّة and أُلُوهِيَّة and His names and attributes and every description He is perfect and complete. And this is because people nowadays, they might use this and they say that the Prophet ﷺ, he was a Sayyid as well, meaning he had some of these aspects of deity or godliness.
نقول هو سيد ولد آدم عليه الصلاة والسلام.
So we say that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the chief or the best or most virtuous, i.e. the Sayyid of the children of Adam.
أعلى وصف يوصف به النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وبهذا أرشد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه عبد لا يعبد ورسول لا يكذب. نعم.
But the best and most praiseful of praises that can be given to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or the most virtuous of descriptions that can be given to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is to say that which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam ordered us to say. We say that he is Abdullah. He is the worship of Allah, and therefore he's not worshipped himself. He is the worship of Allah, and he is not worshipped. And we say that he's Rasulullah, he's the messenger of Allah, and we don't disbelieve in him.
فَيَنْبَغِي لِكُلْ مَنْ قِيلَ لَهُ سَيِّدْ أَنْ يَقُولَ السَّيِّدُ اللَّهُ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى كَمَا قَالَ النَّبِي صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ.
So therefore, if anybody else, or if somebody comes to you and calls you Sayyid, then you say, rather, a Sayyid is Allah, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said.
ثم انقلبت الأحوال في هذه الأيام.
And now the times have changed in these days.
وأصبحنا نقول للكافرين سادة.
And now we say even regarding the disbelievers, السادة, i.e. they are the Sayyids.
بل أكثر من هذا.
Rather, even more severe than this.
تقول للكافرات كذلك.
That now you say to the disbelieving women the same thing.
المهم نعم. طيب. بعد هذا انتهى بهذا ولله الحمد من هذا القسم من المناهي اللفظية والفاظ الشركية وبعض الشركيات من القسم التاسع ثم أراد أن يختم هذا الكتاب رحمه الله. نعم.
So by this chapter mentioning these things, the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, he completed the ninth section of this book, the ninth of the ten sections, and that is regarding those phrases or expressions or terms which are prohibited.
ختم بهذا الباب كأنه يقول لك أن من قبح الشرك كون مسبة لله. نعم.
And then he brought the tenth section, which is the ending of this chapter. And it's as if the author is saying to you that from the evil effects of a shirk is that a person is insulting or reviling Allah.
وهؤلاء الكفار نسأل العافية والسلامة.
And those disbelievers, we ask Allah for safety and pardoning.
يسبون الله سبحانه وتعالى بالشرك سواء كان بالقول أو بالفعل.
They insult and revile Allah with a shirk, whether it is reviling and insulting Him with their tongue or through their actions.
وأنت موحد.
And you are a person of tawheed.
لابد أن تحذر من الشرك وتأتي بالتوحيد.
And you are a person of at-tawheed, and therefore you have to be cautious and be aware of ash-shirk and make sure you fulfill and bring at-tawheed.
وبتوحيد الله يكون تعظيم لله سبحانه وتعالى.
And by you establishing and maintaining and learning the tawheed of Allah, in this you are exalting and honoring and respecting Allah.
أو كأنه يقول لك إنه مهما تعلمت وعملت ودعوت أي بالتوحيد لابد أن يكون عمل المرء فيه نقص لأنه قد يغتر المرء بدراسة كتاب التوحيد وقل أنا موحد وأتممت دراسة كتاب التوحيد وكذا لابد أن يكون فيه توحيده شيء من النقص. نعم.
Or it's as if the author is saying by bringing this ending, it's as if he's saying that look, don't you be deceived that now you are a person of at-tawheed. Meaning a person, he might be deceived, he might say, look, I've studied tawheed, I finished completing the kitab at-tawheed, I am now a muwahid. However much tawheed you have to know that there will always be deficiency in you.
أو أن المؤلف على ما ذكرنا نظر في صحيح البخاري قبل أن يؤلف هذا الكتاب وجد أن البخاري رحمه الله تعالى ختم بكتاب التوحيد كتاب الصحيح.
Or we can also say that Imam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, before authoring and writing this book, Kitab al-Tawheed, he looked into the book of Imam Bukhari, Sahih al-Bukhari, and he found that Imam Bukhari, he also ended his book, his compilation with the chapter of al-Tawheed, Kitab al-Tawheed.
هل معنى هذا أن البخاري رحمه الله تعالى يرى أن التوحيد آخر ما يكون؟
Does this therefore mean that Imam Bukhari, his opinion is that the last thing they should know or study is التوحيد؟
لا، بدأ هو بالتوحيد في باب بدء الوحي، بدأ الوحي للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بالتوحيد. نعم.
Rather, he began his book Sahih Bukhari by mentioning التوحيد. He mentioned كتاب or باب كتاب بدء الوحي, the chapter of the beginning of revelation, and this was التوحيد.
وختم بالتوحيد تفاؤلا أن الله سبحانه وتعالى يختم له بالتوحيد. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يختم لنا وله وللمؤلف بالتوحيد آمين.
نعم. And then he ended his book by mentioning التوحيد, being optimistic and having hope and hoping that Allah will give him or take his life upon التوحيد.
وختم بحديث كلمتان خفيفتان على اللسان حبيبتان الرحمن ثقيلتان في الميزان, كأنه يقول يا رب ثقل موازين بهذا الكتاب كما ثقلت سبحان الله بحمد سبحان الله العظيم. نعم.
And Imam al-Bukhari in his Sahih, the last hadith he mentioned is a statement of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كلمتان خفيفتان على اللسان, two phrases or two words that are light upon the tongue and yet they are heavy upon the scales, and then he mentioned them, Subhanallah bihamdihi, Subhanallah al-Azim. It's as if the author is saying that, O Allah, just as you have made these two phrases and these two words heavy upon the scales, then also make my scales heavy.
وهنا المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى ذكر كثف السماوات والأرض والعرش والكرسي, كأنه يقول يا رب ثقل موازيني بهذا الكتاب كما ثقلت السماوات والأرض والعرش والكرسي. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجزي هذا المؤلف خير الجزاء. نعم. بعد هذا أتم المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى هذا الكتاب. نريد أخواننا أننا يعني نعرف أننا من هذا اليوم تنتهي الدورة. هذا كلام لا يصح. من هذا اليوم تبدأ الدورة عندنا. نعم.
So by this chapter, then now a person could say that our conference is now ending. And this isn't something which is correct. Rather, we need to say that with the ending of this book, with the ending of this conference, now our dawra is starting.
هذه الدورة ليست إلا مفاتيح للعلم.
So this conference, it is nothing except keys towards knowledge, opening the doors of knowledge.
فالواجب علينا.
So therefore, the obligation upon us.
أن نبدأ من هذه الساعة.
Is that from this hour we begin?
تبدأ بالتوحيد.
That you begin with التوحيد.
الأصول الثلاثة.
Knowing and learning the three fundamental principles.
ثم القواعد الأربع.
And then after this, the book, the four fundamental principles.
ثم الدروس المهمة.
And then the important lessons which are written by Sheikh bin Baz.
ثم كتاب التوحيد.
And then that we study and we revise and we learn كتاب التوحيد.
ثم العقيدة الواسطية.
And then after this we learn العقيدة الواسطية.
ثم بلوغ المرام.
And then after this we study بلوغ المرام, a book in hadith.
إخواننا إلى متى ونحن تضيع علينا الأوقات؟ إلى متى؟
So brothers, for how long are we going to carry on wasting our time?
لا يشك أحد أن الهجرة واجب.
Nobody doubts that To make hijrah is an obligation.
هذا لا يشك في أحد لأن هذه فتوى كبار العلماء وإحنا نعرف هذا.
And nobody doubts this. In fact, this is the fatwa of the senior scholars, and we know this.
وأنت الآن في خطر.
And now, right now, you are in danger.
محارب.
You are being fought against.
من الشيطان.
From the shaitan.
من الكافرين.
From the disbelievers.
من المنافقين.
From the hypocrites.
من الحاسدين.
From those who are jealous.
من نفسك.
From your own desires and your own soul.
ماذا تصنع؟
So what therefore do you do?
تلتجئ إلى الله.
You have to turn to Allah.
تهاجر ولا بد.
That you have to make hijrah, you have to migrate.
يعتذر بعض الناس يقول لدي كذا وكذا وكذا. طيب. غير الآن نيتك.
Some people they make an excuse and they say that I'm remaining in this country because I have this and this and this. The Shaykh said, okay, but from now, change your intention.
في أن تكون في هذه البلاد داعية إلى الله.
That's the only reason why you are in this country is because you are a caller to Allah.
تبذل غاية الجهد في الدعوة إلى الله.
That you should strive and make an utmost effort in calling to Allah.
وإلا فأنت آثم.
And if it is any other reason apart from this, then you are sinning.
يا أخواننا. إذا لم نبتدئ هؤلاء بالدعوة بدأونهم.
Oh brothers, if we don't begin and initiate our da'wah towards those people, then they will initiate their da'wah to us.
نحن في خطر.
So we are in danger.
أولادنا في خطر أكبر.
Our children are even in more greater danger.
إذا لم نتعلم نحن من يعلم أولادنا؟
If we don't learn ourselves, then who is it that is going to teach our children?
إلى متى؟ وفي كل دورة نحن ندرس الأصول الثلاثة الأصول الثلاثة الأصول الثلاثة متى ننتقل متى نحن ندرس الأصول الثلاثة للناس متى نعلم الناس يا أخواننا هذه حجة قامت عليكم الآن درستم هذه الكتب فلا يمكن أن في كل دورة تدرس هذه الكتب لا بد ترتقي.
So for how long and how many conferences are we going to come back and again teach the same book, Al-Usul al-Thalatha, the three fundamental principles, and the next Dora, and the next conference, and the next conference. When are you now going to learn and memorize and then go out and teach? It can't be the case that every time we come, then we're doing the same thing because we haven't learned. You have to now progress and go on to the next stage.
Hirakhl, سأل أبو سفيان رضي الله عنه عن أصحاب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. هل يزيدون؟ قال نعم. اليوم إذا كنا لا نكثر سواد أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم فمعنى هذا أننا لسنا على الجادة لأنه قال هل يزيدون؟ قال نعم يزيدون.
So Hercules, when he met Abu Sufyan and when he spoke to him, he said to him that do the companions of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم are they always improving and getting bigger and getting greater number? And he said yes, of course.
والله تسأل يوم القيامة.
By Allah, you will be asked on the day of resurrection.
عن النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Regarding the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
هل أدى الأمانة؟
That did he fulfill his trust?
هل نصح الأمة؟
That did he advise the أمة؟
هل بلغ هذا الدين؟
Did he convey this religion?
هل جاهد في الله حق جهاد؟
Did he strive and make jihad in the way of Allah as it ought to be done?
تقول نعم.
And you will say yes.
يسألك الله سبحانه وتعالى عن هذا الذي جاء به النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And then Allah will question you regarding that which the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم came with.
هل تعلمت؟
Did you learn and study?
هل عملت؟
Did you act and implement?
هل دعوت؟
Did you call to it, call others and give da'wah?
هل صبرت؟
Were you patient?
هل جاهدت نفسك؟
Did you fight and strive against your soul?
قبل أن تفكر في مجاهدة الكفار والمنافقين والشيطان.
Before you even thought about striving and making jihad against the kuffar and the munafiqin and the shayateen.
بعض الناس يقول أنه على طريقة السلف.
Some people they say that I am upon the way of the salaf.
هذا أمر واجب. واجب أن نكون على طريقة السلف.
So this is something which is an obligation, meaning it is an obligation for every single person to be upon the way of the Salaf.
لكن هل اتباع السلف كلمة قلب اللسان؟
But a person following the methodology of the Salaf, is it just a word that a person says upon his tongue?
لا بد يصدق العمل.
Rather, your actions have to testify to it.
تكون في كل المسائل كما ذكرنا في الاقتداء بإبراهيم عليه الصلاة والسلام إمام وقدوة.
So in every single aspect, You have to be like this. We mentioned about Ibrahim, alayhi salam, six things. He was an imam, he was an example.
تكثر من الطاعة وتداوم عليها.
And he used to increase in his righteous deeds, and he was always consistent upon his righteous deeds.
محافظة على الصلاة المفروضة.
He used to preserve, or a person should preserve the daily prayers.
مع الجماعة.
In congregation.
الصف الأول.
In the first row.
الأذكار.
And the remembrances and the supplication.
قراءة أوراد من القرآن, حفظ القرآن, إخواننا السلف يحفظوا في كل يوم.
Reciting your daily portion of the Quran, memorizing the Quran, the Salaf. This is what they used to do with the Quran.
يا إخواننا في الغالب أنه لا ينقصنا علم, ينقصنا عمل.
In most cases and in majority of times, it's not knowledge which is deficient in us, rather it's the implementation, the actions.
فلا بد أن نتغير.
So therefore, we have to change and progress.
من هذا اليوم.
From this day,
تضع لنفسك برنامج.
That you put a program for yourself, you have a schedule for yourself.
تلغي هذه الملهيات.
You leave off these time-wasting things.
تجعل كل ما حولك يساعدك في طلب العلم.
Everything that is around you, you should make it or use it to help you in seeking knowledge.
سماع, تستمع دائما للدروس العلمية. الدروس العلمية لا إلى القيل والقال.
When you're listening to things, then you should listen to scholarly lessons or lessons of knowledge. Scholarly lessons, not backbiting and spreading rumors.
تبتعد عن الشبه ولا تنصت إليها أبدا إطلاقا.
That you stay away from the doubts. You don't listen to the doubts at all.
نجتمع على ما اجتمع عليه الصحابة رضوان الله عليهم ولا نفترق.
That we congregate and we unite upon those things and those matters which the companions congregate and united upon, and that we don't become divided.
نأمر بالمعروف وننهى عن المنكر على ما توجب الشريعة.
And that you should enjoin the goodness and forbid the evil according to that which the Sharia has obligated.
أول ما تبدأ بصلاح النفس.
The first thing that you start with is rectifying your own self.
ثم من حولك.
And then after this, those people who are around you.
تدعو الله سبحانه وتعالى.
That you supplicate to Allah.
التوفيق والسداد.
You ask Allah for التوفيق and السداد, for guidance.
توفيق يدلك على الطريق. اللهم اهدني وسددني. اهدني وسددني أي أن الله يبين لك الحق ثم يوفقك في سلوك هذا الحق.
So you ask Allah and you supplicate to him for two things, التوفيق and السداد. التوفيق is you supplicating to Allah that he shows you the right way, he shows you the guidance, he shows you the right path. And then as-sidad, that he gives you the ability to actually implement and follow and traverse that path and that guidance.
ترك الفتوى ولا يمكن أن نتكلم بكلمة نفتي بها.
And now, then we leave off giving fatawa, i.e. we start giving Islamic rulings.
حتى نقل فتوى تقول سمعت أحد المشايخ يفتي بمثل ما لديك أو تسأل عنه. لأنه قد يكون لهذا حال وهذا حال آخر مخالف عنه.
Even in terms of transmitting the fatwa of the scholars, this is something you have to be careful of, because the scenario or the person questioning the fatwa of the scholar maybe has a specific situation, a specific scenario, and this is different to the person and the scenario of the person that you are giving this fatwa to.
تشتغل بعيوبك عن عيوب الآخرين.
And that you should concentrate on your own sins rather than the defects and the shortcomings of others.
لا يمكن أن تحكم على أحد كائن من كان إلا ما كان ظاهرا مثل سب الرب أنه كفر أكبر. لا تحكم على أي إنسان بالكفر أو الفسق أو التبديع أو ما إلى ذلك, لأن هذا لكبار العلماء.
It's not allowed for you to ever make a judgment on anybody, whoever that person is, unless it is something very, very clear, like we mentioned, somebody insulting Allah. Don't ever get yourself into at-takfir, calling Muslims to be non-Muslims, or at-tabdir, saying that this person who is upon the Sunnah, he is now an innovator, or these names, or at-tafsir, saying he's a sinner or a disobedient person, because this is the job and the role of the older senior scholars.
At-ta'awun ma'a ba'dhana al-ba'd, ikhwana.
And also we have to cooperate and help each other.
نكون كالبنيان.
That we are like one building.
يد واحدة.
One hand.
نتعاون على ما
That we unite and work, we work with each other and we cooperate with each other in that which the Salaf united and worked with each upon.
أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يوفق الجميع لما يحب ويرضاه. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى لي ولكم التوفيق والسداد. وأسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يعصمنا من الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن وأن يرنا الحق حقا ويرزقنا اتباع الباطل باطلا ويرزقنا اجتنابه. وأنا والله أخواننا يعني كما قلت في أول الدورة كما قال معاوية رضي الله عنه, معاوية رضي الله عنه خطب في الناس وقال يا أيها الناس إني لست بخيركم ولكنني والله خير لكم. أنا والله لا يعني أصل إلى مرتبة واحد منكم بل أنا أدنى مرتبة, لكن أردنا أخواننا في هذه الدورة أن تكون هذه الدورة لله, نتعلم فيها العقيدة, نتعلم فيها ما هو معلوم من الدين بالضرورة, نبتعد عن الشرك والمنكرات والبدع. نعم, فإن يعني حصل مني تقصير أو يعني قد أكون أسأت لواحد منكم أو كذا فأنا أعتذر, والعذر عند كرام الناس مقبول. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يعفو عني وعنكم, الله أعلم, صلى الله على نبينا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم, وأستودعكم الله الذي لا تضيع ودائعه. نعم.